Yo, this is Danny from Upon a Burning Body, and you're watching barebonesmusic.com.
Evil G, barebonesmusic.com. I'm here with Danny from Upon a Burning Body. Danny?
What's that?
Barely made it here.
Yeah,
he's got the winter gear on. It's cold out. You're from Texas, so you're not used to this.
Yeah, we're bundled up.
We appreciate you making it here.
I'm glad I made it.
Let's talk about your debut album, The World Is Ours.
Let's do it.
Tell us all about it.
It took a long time to make. You know, 5 years coming. Mm-hmm. About 5.5 actually, and you know, it's just basically about our very hard struggle to make it and the things that we've been through and had to overcome, and in hope that one day we would be here today doing stuff like we're doing right now.
Okay. Well, I was going to ask this for later, but this seems like a perfect opportunity. You know, you're quite the DIY band in San Antonio, and
right.
So talk about that transformation and finally getting signed to Sumerian Records and getting to this point.
You know, in San Antonio, it's not much different than it ever has been. You know, we've just grinded it out, and we've done everything that we've done, and we've mentioned that we wanted to, you know, put the city on the map and stuff like that. There's no real like big bands that come out there, so we wanted to do something like that, and it was very special to us that we had the potential to do something in that regard. So for us to be out here now, you know, doing it and to be able to say we're from San Antonio means a lot to us. So the city, you know, they stand behind us 110%, and you know, we're just glad to be from there. So, you know, it's almost like, you know, being signed to a record label or not, it just helps put the name on the map,
right?
Really, to be signed. So it means a lot. But as far as the shows go and stuff like that, it's the same. It's all love. It's all family there, you know.
Well, let's talk about the theme of your record. Tell me the whole idea behind the Al Pacino, like, every song title is an Al Pacino movie.
Yeah.
Your first video for Carlito's Way has got the whole gangster thing going on it.
It does.
Tell me about that, man. Tell me about that theme you took.
It's an idea that the label had for some time, and you know, I don't know if they presented it to other bands. You know, that's not my my business to ask. But they asked me one day, like when we had already signed the deal, they're like, hey, I got this idea, you know, and like it wasn't a full on like set, like this is exactly how it's gonna go. But it was a general like, you know, some like a mobster type theme or
right.
like something to go with that. And immediately I was like, we're down. Like, you know, I don't have to ask. You know, we love bands like that, like Kiss and Slipknot and Gwar and stuff like that. So
right.
for us to be able to have the opportunity to maybe do something and make an impact later down the line like they have for us was very special. So we took it and we're running with it. And, you know, we have that mafia, like kind of mafia theme thing going. And, you know, what you see on our MySpace pictures, new promo pictures, that's actually what we wear on stage. So,
okay.
So yeah, we don't just take the pictures, come here and play regular.
Right.
We, you know.
So you carry that theme all the way through.
All the way. Yeah.
Huh. That's interesting.
All the way.
Well, you know, you guys are in the extreme hardcore metal scene. But I've heard your record, and you know, tell me how your band, how you differentiate yourselves from other bands in this genre. I mean, what do you bring to the table that you think people aren't going to normally hear from, I don't know, say Carnifex or, you know, some of the bands you're on tour with?
Well,
what's your unique style? Because your vocal style, you do some interesting things with your vocals as well.
Yeah, I tried on the record to do things that I would enjoy hearing if I was a fan, you know, and that's the way I look at the way we write. I don't write too much. I mean, it's my lyrics are stuff that comes from the heart, but tones and stuff I think are where you have to become more of a fan before you know, just an artist, because you want to put out, to me, you want to put out something that kids want to hear, and that's a little different, and that's what I tried to do on the record. But I didn't want to overdo it, you know,
right.
So to where it's like, well, what do I do on the second one, you know, like
right,
so
yeah.
keep it slow moving up, you know. Kids want to hear different stuff, they want to hear the progression, so you know, we give them a taste, and then next record we'll give them more and stuff and more variety, hopefully. But
So you did Carlito's Way, which was pretty cool. It looked pretty fun.
Yeah, it was fun.
Especially since you get the last shot.
Yeah, that's real.
Go watch the video, you'll understand what
I'm
saying.
And it's real liquor in there.
But you went ahead and you've already shot a video for Intermission.
Yes.
With the same, with Jason Hansen?
Correct? Scott.
Scott Hansen. Scott Hansen. Scott Hansen. What are people going to see?
Oh, man, you're going to just see... You're just going to see home at its best, what we do just all the time. You know, the people in the video are, they're not actors. You know, everybody's real. The bikers, we got, you know, big biker guys in there, Harley Davidson, everything Harley Davidson, low riders, show cars. We got a car club, actually two car clubs that came out, and I mean, it's the real deal. Kids came out. We told them to dress up, you know, as best they could. They came. We had to get them there at like 10 in the morning before a show went on in our hometown at the White Rabbit. We filmed it. The White Rabbit was kind enough to let us use their place of business and a back house that they own and the parking lot. So we just, you know, we got dogs, we got girls, we got, you know, like really cool show dogs with sunglasses, we got motorcycles, we got low riders, we got beer, we got weed, you know, we just do it up, and it's just a party, you know. And we had the greatest time making it, and you know, big thanks to the kids in San Antonio that came out and everybody that came out and supported the video, and it was just a great time. So basically you're gonna see us partying and having a good time in the video. That's it, you know.
Cool. Well, we're looking forward to that. Now, based on your gangster attire, and I have to ask this question, there's two questions I'm gonna have to ask, and you can say no, but no. I'm gonna have to ask them. The Canadian border situation,
right?
Twice you were denied entry into Canada because of some, what's the story? I've read it online. I've seen little bits and pieces. There have been reports where you even said, I was just a phone call and we got through and no problem. But what was the deal?
See, we went, you know, day before, as usual, the bands will, you know, we'd been there before, so we were good, and then we all had passports. Day before, you know, you get your stuff together. It's like, hey, this is the sheet you're going to need. Right. This cut, but everything in order. It's like, okay, you got a little folder. Drive over there, you know. We get there, and here you go, you know, be polite and for some reason, I guess on the sheet or whatever the problem was, it said that the venue was a bar and it was open throughout the week as a bar. Right. So to be able to have to go play there in a bar situation, you would need a work permit. But we were like, it's not, and we're exempt for those because it's not a bar. Like, they have a bar, but they're only open when there's shows. So it's not like if there's no show, there's still a bar.
Right. Okay.
So that makes you exempt, and we're telling the lady and. She was just like, it was a thing where as soon as we walked in and came up to the window, you could tell, like, she doesn't like us for some reason. Maybe the way we look, maybe because our skin's a little too brown, or I don't know, but she wasn't a very nice lady. And I hope she slips and falls in the snow or something, I don't know, and hurts her back.
But, so that had nothing to do with the gangster thing?
I mean, we weren't dressed like that. We were just regular. And
there was just a lot of rumors about it. I was interested because of it.
Yeah, there was a lot of things going around with that, and I couldn't tell you why she didn't let us in. It was one lady, and we even got the promoter on the phone. We got the owner of the club on the phone. They faxed, notarized letters stating we were exempt to the border. Still didn't get in. I don't know if you're watching this. I don't know if you could cuss on here, otherwise I would.
Go tell her what you think,
bitch, man. You know, like, just let us in the country. We just want to take your money. That's all.
So Canada,
yeah, Canada.
Welcome
yeah.
them back. Come on,
Jesus, man.
Get, next lighten time. Up a little bit. So let's wrap this up by talking about you in this tour up here, and you know, you guys, you know, you're fresh. You're right out of the box here. We got coming for 2011.
2011, let's see, we got
confirmed right now, or at least
right now that I can say that's confirmed out is we got the Oceano headliner.
Okay. Cool.
So I think that one, let me think, that one is the opener is, oh man, I forget their name. I breathe.
Yeah.
Yeah, new Sumerian band, so I should know this, right. Sorry. Then the Great Commission, I think, is gonna follow that, and then us, and then For the Fallen Dreams, and Oceana. That's confirmed. We have another tour confirmed, but I don't know if I'll get in trouble. We got the Word Alive. We're support. We're doing support on Word Alive. So it's a good jump in. It's a good jump in. The status of the show and stuff. So should look good if anything. You know. So got that
exclusive. As always. So let me one question while I'm thinking about it. You talked about Sumerian. They seem to be quite the up and coming label for
on fire
this type of music. Yeah. I mean, everything from After the Burial to Asking Alexandria, you guys, I Breather. I mean, there's all kind. I mean, what's that label like?
Oh, the label is just the owner Ash and the label manager Sean, two of the coolest dudes, and they're just. To me, they're just genius on the bands that they pick. You know, I mean, before we were signed, we would see the bands that they would sign. It's like, geez, man, we got to be a part of that. You
right,
know, so
yeah.
That was our label that we didn't shop to anybody. I just kept bugging them and knocking on the door. You know, Ash, I kept knocking, and that's it. And it was just that was the label of choice. We wanted, we had to have it. We weren't gonna stop till they gave it to us, and they did, you know, so, and we're doing great, you know, they're nice, they're treating us very well, we couldn't be happier on a label, so, perfect, you know.
Awesome, all right, that's my suck up to Sumerian since I know George. Danny, thanks for sitting down with us,
hey,
man.
Thank you so much for having me.
Glad you made it here safe,
yeah,
through
too.
This treacherous snow,
me
and
too.
Hopefully you enjoy the warmth of California here in 10 days.
Yeah, so. I can't wait.
Best of luck with the album, and I can't wait to see the next video, man.
Oh, man, thank you. It's
all
coming
right?
out soon.
So check it out. The World is Ours, out now. The original Gangsters.
Yeah.
Right here.
Yeah.
A Pod Burning Body. Danny,
yeah.
Thanks, man.
Thank you.